We came up with the idea about the topic of domestic violence, and we knew that we wanted to include many voices, and we wanted to work with community of survivors, and the form of it, the exhibition form, came afterwards.
In the process, we understood that this is the right way for us as artists to speak about it. And also when we were in the process, we were looking to other artworks that are connected to this topic of domestic violence. And we were thinking, what is missing? What we could do that other people have or artists haven't done yet? And for us, it was important, yes, to give the voices and to allow the objects to speak, because mostly these objects are the witnesses, the only witnesses,
the silent witnesses,
yes, that have witnessed all the domestic abuse.
To our surprise, it was difficult to get the stories from the women, from the ones who have experienced domestic violence. And that was exactly the opposite of what we thought. We thought once we put out the call and we invite, that there will be stories will be flooding in. But it didn't happen. So we really had to work with ways to get women to speak or to invite them to speak. And I would say that the project starts from the moment we try to find these women. It's not only the exhibition, it's all the work we do before. It's also part of the project. Also, the exhibition form allowed us to include women in making of the exhibition. In Riga, we had really women working with us for a duration of 2 months. And they were very crucial in our choices also in the museum and how it looked in the end.
And also about the process, it was very important to also gain trust, because only when we gain actually trust as artists and also as a project, only then women started to share their objects and stories. It was very important for us to give opportunity for women to speak and speak about their stories, because a lot of times they're not believed. And here we trust and we give our trust and we say, yes, we believe you, and we take your story to the museum. And expectations when we started, of course, our biggest expectation that we're going to get the stories overflowing, but in the same time, there's still very big burden of silence in Latvia and in Poland. There are so many similarities in the situations in domestic abuse, and that was a bit shocking that there are so many different people involved, but they choose to act so similarly. And in some of the Polish stories, we get the same, that there are the same choices.
But also, I think both us and both as a visitor, if you come here, what you get is that you see different shades of violence. And I think one of very powerful comments that we got during the exhibition in Riga was people saying, I didn't know it also counts. So sometimes you only start to recognize violence when you see it in a context. And as one of our participants said before working with us, she thought that violence is a black eye, and now she really knows the difference. That it can start on very verbal level, on emotional level, and it also counts. It's how it starts, and then it actually tends to develop. And the earlier you recognize it, the easier it will be for you to get away or get your friend away. I don't know if we make difference, but we definitely got response, and we think we really could change something for several women, and that's already for us an achievement. But when we see transformation in these people with whom we worked, or the people who came to the reading marathon, I could see the transition or transformation with my own eyes, so that I would say that we achieved something. Mm-hmm. Yes.